There's a lady in England who was crippled. She had some feeling because she could feel pain in her feet, but she couldn't walk. Paralyzed, partially paralyzed, couldn't walk. Young lady, early teenager maybe, might have been 13, 14, I don't know exactly. But she was reading in the Bible, James 5, 14 and 15, call for the elders of the church. So she called the church that she was familiar with and got the pastor on the phone, and he said that he didn't believe that verse. He didn't believe that was for us today. Well, somehow or another, the assistant pastor heard about it, and she talked to him on the phone, or he said, I'll go. So the assistant pastor, he apparently did believe in the verse, even though the pastor didn't. So the assistant pastor visited her in her home, anointed her with oil, prayed for her, and nothing happened that she could see or feel. Well, he left, and she started saying to people, hands were laid upon me, I've been anointed with oil, the Lord raises me up. She asked people to read the Bible. Look at my Bible. Get my Bible there. Open it to James 5, 14 and 15. Read that. And then she would say, this has been done to me. I've been anointed with oil. The prayer of faith has been prayed over me. This says the Lord raises me up. This has been done to me. Anytime anybody would visit, she's there in the bed. She's paralyzed, partially paralyzed, can't walk, a cripple. So she's there in the bed, and she would say, get my Bible. Read James 5, 14 and 15, and she'd say, this has been done to me. She did that for 6 months without wavering, undaunted. Anybody that visited, she'd say, this has been done to me. The prayer of faith has been prayed. I've been anointed with oil. This has been done. 6 months went by, then she had a seizure and got worse. Her legs now drawn up even more. And pain in her feet, the lower legs. She'd feel the pain, but she couldn't use her legs. And her mother, taking care of her, would just cry before the Lord. Why won't you heal my daughter? Just cry. Mama, this has been done to me. I've been anointed with oil. The prayer of faith has been prayed. This says the Lord raises me up. Mama, this has been done to me. Another 3 months went by, now a total of 9 months. Jesus Christ appeared to her in her bedroom. Jesus Christ appeared to her in a vision in her bedroom and said these words, arise in this thy strength. And immediately her legs received strength, and she got up out of that bed and stood there by the bed and shouted, Mom! She's in England. They say, Mom. I would say, Mama. Mama! But she said, Mom. Mom! And the mother came and opened the door, saw her standing there by the bed, and fainted. But she stood on the word for 9 months. Well, I'm still a cripple. How can you tell? It has to be by what you see. This has been done to me. Well, why did it take 9 months? I don't know. But you know, after she was healed, she didn't care why it took 9 months. After she received, she didn't care. Well, we're praying. You know you can't make a tomato ripen any quicker by praying. I mean, God could do a miracle, but I've never heard of it. There's a system. That's God's system. And Jesus said the whole kingdom of God operates just like man putting seed in the ground. What happens is people don't believe it. They'll pray. And then the next day when they see that it's still there, they'll pray again. Now, if you need prayer, get prayer. If a dog came and dug up your tomatoes, well, let's plant some more. But we need to know what we're doing. Amen. I've prayed for people the next day. I hear that somebody else prayed for them. Well, that prayer's in unbelief unless they just didn't know. Somebody say amen. Didn't they know that they were just prayed for yesterday? Well, then don't pray. Praise God and thank God and encourage them. Well, yeah, but Brother Tony, it's been 3 weeks. Well, this lady went 9 months. Well, I'm getting a little discouraged. It's been 3 weeks. Well, this lady, I don't know how discouraged she got. She never voiced it. Anytime anybody came over, she'd say, get my Bible. Read James 5, 14 and 15. And she's talking to people that didn't even believe in it. But she believed in it. And she said, this has been done to me. Amen. So I'm going to stand. And when the devil brings things to my thoughts, mind, circumstances, or other people, and sometimes they're Christians, well-meaning people. Brother Tony, let me pray for you. Now, I don't usually have that, but I know people who do because they still look sick. Let me pray for you. No. The doctor wanted to help Susan with that basal cell carcinoma. Well, he doesn't know faith. But you know, Christians will do the same thing. Amen. I'm glad I'm hooked up with Susan. Because if she sees symptoms, she's not encouraging me to do something other than faith would do. If I see symptoms, I'm not encouraging her to do something other than what faith would do. But you know, people have others in their own household that'll encourage them contrary to faith. And you got to live with those people. Sometimes you have to be nice. But I'm glad I'm hooked up. We don't talk sickness, but we don't act on it either. Somebody say, well, you ought not talk it. Well, I think sometimes you ought not pray it. Brother Tony, let me pray for you. Why? Well, I see. Well, you're going by what you see. I'm not one to do that too much. People think he doesn't care. Or he doesn't know. I might have known before you ever saw him. I'll be in the spirit of prayer and I'll know some things. That will affect what I teach and preach. But it won't change how I act when I'm around them. Is anybody listening to me? I'll get into prayer and I'll hear things. I'm hearing somebody. I don't know when they said it, but I heard them say it. That'll change what I teach. But he was, well, I don't want Pastor Tony to know. He probably already does. Not always. Not always. But sometimes. You remember Elisha and Gehazi? When Naaman got healed, he was wanting to give Elisha just all kinds of things, clothes and money. And Elijah said, no, you can't buy healing. You can't buy God's miracle. That's why evangelists ought not take the offering right after the greatest miracle occurs. That's wrong. It's just wrong. And they'll lose the anointing over that. I mean, it is a miracle. They had the anointing, but they'll lose it. I've seen that more than once. But Gehazi went to Naaman and said, he's changed his mind. You know, some people have visited, and he doesn't want anything for himself, but he wants something for them. And Naaman was just so thrilled with the healing that he gave Gehazi twice what he asked for. And Gehazi came back, and Elisha said, where have you been? And what did Gehazi say? Nowhere, my Lord. Well, Gehazi knew that he's hooked up with the prophet of God. But he knows that the prophet of God doesn't know everything, or else he wouldn't have been so foolish to try to get away with that. He doesn't know everything. Because if you think he knows everything, you're pretty stupid to try to get away with that. So he doesn't know everything, but he'll know what the Lord reveals. So Elisha said to Gehazi, didn't my spirit go with you? When you joined yourself to that chariot, I saw it. Is it a time to receive gifts? And because you've done this, the leprosy that was on Naaman is now going to be on you and your children. And you don't hear anything else about Gehazi. Now you think about what, I preached a sermon one time, the man that might have been. Because Elisha had a double portion of Elijah, didn't he? Elisha had a double portion of Elijah because he served him faithfully for 20 years. And then even when Elijah gave him a test, he said, you stay here, I'm going to go there. Elisha said, no, you're not. I'm going with you. Gave him that test 3 times. It's a test. It's a test to see how hungry you are. And Elijah participated in the test. You stay here, I'm going to go there. Not so. And Elijah did that 3 times. Well, Gehazi had an opportunity to have what Elisha had, and maybe double. Not a Thursday night prayer service or Friday night. When he used to have it on Friday nights, didn't he? Every Friday night was double portion night. I won't mention his name. Good minister, I enjoyed his meetings, but I knew that wasn't right. Every Friday night in his tent meetings, it was double portion night. And he'd everyone who wants a double portion, come and he'd lay hands on the people. I mean, there'd be hundreds. I've been there. Hundreds going through that line for a double portion. I thought, boy, if Elisha known, is this easy? Just have somebody lay hands on me, I get a double portion. Boy, that's a whole lot easier than what I did with Elijah. Elijah, I had to be with him 20 years. You can get it just a Friday night prayer service. Wow. Who knew? Wow. But people love that kind of thing. But I think about the man that might have been. What could Gehazi have done if he had stayed with the Lord instead of the love of money or the temptation of the flesh? Well, he could have repented. I suppose he didn't, because I know God's merciful. He maybe went away bitter. We don't hear much about him. I know God's merciful. So Gehazi probably went away bitter. Amen. Well, he didn't know everything, but Elisha knew that. Well, sometimes in prayer, I don't know everything, but I see some things. And it'll change how I pray. It'll change how I teach and preach. It's always motivated by mercy and compassion. I want to help them. Did you see what they did? Yeah. Did you hear what they said? Yeah. Did you see the wavering? Yeah. Did you see their wondering? Yeah. I heard that. Now, I'm not talking to anybody. I'm just saying hypothetically. Somebody could ask me these questions. Yeah. I know they're wavering. I know they're yielding. I'm praying and holding them up with love, mercy, compassion, faith. Amen. We need one another, don't we? Turn and tell your neighbor, you need me. Now tell somebody else, and I need you. We need one another. Now I need your love, compassion, grace, mercy, faith, not your judgment, but your love, compassion, faith, mercy, grace. That's what I need. That's what I'm going to give. That's what I need. Amen.